kind of results in a liquid crystalline dendrimers. In general, dendrimers are tree-like structures that are realized on the molecular level, and this is a KED, which was suggested in 19th century and considered primary competition KEA, and also better largeness in magnitude is also one of the representatives. To synthesize a type of structures, either a divergent or convergent growth synthesis could be used, and basically they were synthesized in 1985-1980 for the first time. The high monodispersity of such objects and their regular structure is found some potential applications to radiate. So, for instance, one is a so-called dendritic box, which can be used for drug delivery and contrast agents in medicine, by incorporating some drug inside the box and then releasing it. And also, that system could be used in photonic applications to collect excitation from the shell to the central unit. So what happens if we combine liquid crystalline groups and dendritic structures? This can be combined in the main chain fashion by incorporating mesogens inside the structure or in a sort of side chain fashion, when they are only at the shell of the macromolecule. In this case, we have two tendencies, and one is that the liquid crystalline groups are interacting one with another, and also there is space segregation between the aromatic mesogenic units and the aliphatic structure of the dendrimer itself. And against this tendency is the spherical symmetry of the macromolecule. So at the end, either one or another tendency wins, and it was found that the main point is the density, the packing density of the mesogens on the surface of the molecule. So if it is increasing, then the lamellar symmetric phase are followed by the columnar phase and ubiquitous phase. So this is illustrated on this picture from the experimental studies. And what is important here is that this changes from the symmetric phase to columnar phase with the increase of the temperature is connected with the change of the shape of the macromolecule itself. So it changed from the prolate shape to oblate shape, like this one. And we would like to address in our simulations how the environment is affecting the shape of the liquid crystalline dendrimer. So in general, we developed a semi-atomistic model for the third generation dendrimer. And here also we know the difference in shape between spherical particles and elongated particles is quite good, reproduced quite well as a phase separation between both particles would happen in the real system. So they mix very poor. And first we prepare this liquid crystalline dendrimer in vacuum. Then we relax any internal tension in it. Then we prepare isotropic, pneumatic, and symmetric solvent made up of the same atoms as here. And immerse the dendrimer inside and delete all the particles of the solvent that overlap with the dendrimer. After this, we perform NPT simulation to bring the density back and to bring the solvent back to the phase it has before the dendrimer was immersed. So this is our technical method, and what we found that in the isotropic phase, as would be expected, the dendrimer is isotropic, and we do not show this here. And for the pneumatic and symmetric A solvent, we see that the dendrimer is elongated along the pneumatic direction. Now this takes about 4 nanoseconds to relax, So we see that the whole parameter is reaching the same value as in the soil. Also, what we found out that in semantic case, this is this tendency is less because it is energetically more favorable for some molecules to find the closest, the nearest semantic layer. And so, as the mesogens are not anymore separated as the poles of the molecule. And from the density distribution in different directions, we found that the most deformation is happening in the spaces and in the mesogenic units. And the central core is mostly keeping spherical shape. Since the study was extended further to include the different connection of the mesogenic groups to the dendrimer. So there are four models being considered, and this one is sort of Janus type, a type model with half to half, and this one is with lateral attachment of the mesogenic units, and we found here for this model that the shape is spherical. Also, this constraints it doesn't allow the mesogenic units of the dendrimer in this case to have the same body parameter as the solar, so we see that it is lower. In this way, the general conclusion is that one can study the shape of the dendrimer in different solvents, say in magic, isotropic, semantic, and the shape is changing, and this gives rise to there could be the reason for different bulk phases that are as it can be formed by the dendrimers at higher density, because we consider, of course, only one dendrimer. Of course, we would like to extend this study so we can consider the effect of dendrimer generation, the effect of spacer lengths to decouple both system one from another, translational and tensional diffusion, and the effective interaction between them and approximation by some simple model. Now I would like to address the second problem, which is about simulation of photo-induced deformations in other benzene-containing polymer fields. In 1995, in two independent groups, there was a very interesting phenomenon discovered when the other benzene polymer is subject to the illumination of the interference pattern from two beams with either acute modulation or the polarization vector modulation. Then after the phase grating, people observe formation of the surface relief, surface relief. And so far, several theories are suggested, but no satisfactory theoretical explanation is given. Some related experiments are when the light is illuminated through the mask and in the bright areas, we see that either hills or trenches are observed after some time depending on the type of the polymer being used. So for the liquid crystalline type of polymer with long space that we see the hills, and in the case of amorphous polymer with rigid backbone and short space, we observe trenches. Also related experiments were made on the free floating bubbles of azobenzene, and it was found that the bubble contracts along with the polarization of this polymer and extends polymers. So our aim is to model such different photo-induced deformations depending on the structure, and also to see whether we can see some microscopical mechanism behind these changes. Now we cannot model in scale problem because this is the size of microns and more. So instead we cut a small box in the dark area and light area, and we look at the deformation of the box due to the light. To consider liquid crystalline and amorphous system, we developed two semi-atomistic models. One is weakly coupled with long spacer, another one is strongly coupled with a short spacer and with more rigid backbone. The photoisomerization of azobenzene complex quantum mechanical phenomena, but we need to bring this to the same modeling scale as we use for the polymer. So we used the known fact that in the photostationary state, the transfers of benzenes are found mostly perpendicular to the polarization of the light. Because in this case, the probability to induce the transformation is the lowest. So in this case, we suggest to use the mechanical equivalent as a rotational potential, which tries to reorient these azobenzene groups perpendicular to the field. As a result of these simulations, we found indeed two different, two opposite photo-induced deformations depending on the structure of the poly. So for the liquid crystalline poly, we start from the symmetric phase and apply the field. And after some time, the symmetric phase is destroyed due to reorientation of azobenzene. And if we wait longer, and if the strength of the field is enough, then we see that the symmetric phase is rebuilt in other directions. So this is the same view as here, but here we turn the box to other directions. So we see the same symmetric phase, but being reoriented. If the field is not strong enough, then we have some symmetric-like structure with defects or polydomain symmetric structure. So this is quantitatively studied here when we show that the body parameter along the field and the standard pneumatic body parameter, which we see is dropping down and then again raising it up. So the main thing is that during this photochemical phase transition, which is called in the experiments done by Yamamoto and other researchers, but we see that the box is really contracting. So we see this as this symmetric isotropic transition as the main source of the photo-induced deformation in the liquid crystalline polymer. As a situation in amorphous polymer is quite different. We start from the macroscopic isotropic sample, and then we apply the field and we monitor the deformation of the box. Our first simulations were done at temperature above the glass transition, where everything happens much faster, of course. And we suggested that the same scenario will be held at the temperatures below TG. And this was proven recently by our recent simulations, where we performed extremely long simulations of 150 nanoseconds of the system below the TG. So basically what we found is that the main mechanism for the deformation in this case is rearrangement of the backbones and not the rearrangement of the azobenzene. So it is, I hope you can see it here, that the backbones which are shown by blue are found more extended along the field after 52 nanoseconds. Also, what is very important, when we switch the light off, then we see that this structure is preserved. So it is not destroyed, it is stable, and we can see this on the distribution of the backbone's mass along the field, GZZ, and also the shape of the box stays constant. To conclude, I will present here the slide. So what we did here is classical mechanical modeling. We considered only trans isomers of azobenzenes, and the only effect of the light was reorientation of trans azobenzenes. And of course, this is very crude modeling, but still that was quite enough to demonstrate that the photo-induced deformations are opposite in both sides. So in one side, for the liquid crystalline system, we have that the light is, as the mass of the polymer will above not the light, and for the amorphous system we will see that, that the mass of the polymer will go away from the light. And the main reason is different mechanisms. In one case this is photo-induced order disorder transition in a liquid crystalline subsystem, and in other cases this is as an arrangement of the backbones of the material. One minute, just to show some nice pictures. So the third problem was about modeling of the liquid crystalline elastomers, which is made in collaboration with Mike Allen. And we would like to reproduce some characteristic features of elastic liquid crystalline drug. So if we heat the pneumatic liquid elastomer, then it changes the shape, and if we pull it down, it reproduces the shape. The same is true for the opposite effect when we stretch, for instance, then we induce the order. And both should be reversed. So I will just show our model. It is on a chain with the points intended for cross-linking. And what we see is the symmetric phase is stabilized here, so the temperature shift is about 5 Kelvin estimated. And we see that when we hit the elastomer, and then if we quench it again back to 450 degrees, then it returns to its original order and to its original shape. And it is nicely seen here when we see that the structure is fully recovered. Here we see the backbones, and here including the defect which was here. And another thing is just the pictures. When we stretch the elastomer, we see the effect of a direct reorientation. And if we release the load at some point, the elastomer is returning back to the normal state. But if the temperature is reduced and the load is increased, instead we see the mechanical destruction of the polymer, which was before suggested in experimental studies on applying the load for the elastomer. So basically, I would like to acknowledge funding and computing time. And thank you very much for your attention.
James, thank you very much. Only one question, but very important, please.
I'm not quite sure if it's an important question, but so to your first part, you always depict the dendrimers very well ordered, you know, all the surface layer and so on and so forth. But in your simulation, you see that the dendrimer is a very disordered structure, and the vector genes are decoupled from it. There is no coupling to the dendrimer, right?
The coupling will depend on the length of the spacer that we put in between the mesogene and the dendrimer. And in our case, it was quite long, about 20 atoms. And if, of course, we decrease, we will expect less coupling, more coupling to the structure, and maybe the result will be different.
But you would not expect your dense shell picture again?
It will not be dense, yes. But we haven't did the simulations, we plan to do this. So I don't know the answer.
Okay, thank you. Thank you very much.